Hi there, I'm Beckie Belote from Newport News, Virginia, and I wanted to share a tip. Well, one of the tips is one that I thought everybody knew, but I showed it to my clients yesterday and they didn't know it. So I'm like, well, maybe this is something I've made an assumption about that I should share. And the other one is something that you may not have tried, and it's really not very difficult. So I wanted to give you a tip on how to do that. The tip I'm going to start with is this one on how to do kind of mosaic looks on your pages, pretty easy. So what I'm going to do is change the screen for a second to show you the first skill. All right, and so what you want to do when you're doing this is make sure you're picking two photographs that are the same orientation. Make sure there's also room on either side of them to chop off. All right. Then what you're gonna wanna do for puzzle pieces, you're gonna want one photo to be right side up and you're gonna want one photo to be upside down. All right, so I'm gonna go like this. All right, and I'm gonna start with the right side up one. I'm gonna grab my trimmer, make sure I have my straight blade in, I do. And then what I'm gonna do is I am going to put each of these corners somewhere, okay? The first corner, the top corner, I'm gonna put in the groove that cuts. All right, you should be able to see the groove that cuts on your trimmers. And then I'm gonna put the other corner in as many lines as I want to, but just remember what you pick. So I could do, this corner is on the first black line, or I could do the second black line, or the third black line, it doesn't matter. Whatever you decide. I'm gonna go ahead and do the third black line, all right? I'm gonna make sure that the corner is still in that crease, and I'm just gonna chop it off. All right, still on the third black line, still in the crease, and I can tell by looking in the window. All right, then what I'm gonna do is flip the picture upside down, go to the flat edge that hasn't been cut, do the same thing again. I'm putting the corner in the groove, then I'm sliding this corner over to the third line. One, two, three. So the point is touching that third line, and the other is in the groove. All right, so that gives me this look. All right, the other one, it's upside down for you guys. All right, the other one, I'm gonna do the same thing, but I'm gonna keep the photo upside down. All right, so top corner in the groove. Move it over, one, two, three black lines, and then cut. It's sliding and it's okay. Just make sure you line it up better before you cut it. Then you're gonna flip it over. Go to the flat side, do the same thing. Top corner in the groove, move three over, and then you're going to cut. All right, so now I have my two photos and they should nestle side by side. So the other trick that I wanted to show you is how to mat quickly. All right, so if you look close at my pictures, on this page, you'll see that the matte edge is exactly the same around all of them. So this is something that I do intuitively, and I didn't realize that people weren't doing it also. So I'm gonna go ahead and put an adhesive on this. This is a great one to try because the corners are irregular, or the edges are irregular, to show you how stinking easy it is. So what I'm gonna do is do this edge first. And I'm gonna change my blade for the fun of it. I'm gonna go ahead and put the stamping blade in, which is kind of a newer one. And what I'm gonna do, this time it's important to look in here, in this window right here. I don't wanna see any photo, but if I do, just a little smidgen. So I'm gonna hold it up so that maybe you can see what I'm looking at. I'm not sure if you can see it or not. It's just barely peeking out of the edge here. All right, and if you don't see it, it's okay, because I know that you will look close and see. And it's important that every time you cut, you're gonna do the same thing. So I cut there, I'm gonna rotate it. Doesn't matter that this is on an angle, I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna put the picture in the window. I'm gonna make sure that the photo is just on the edge, and then I'm gonna go. All right, gonna do it again. I'm gonna put the photo in the window. I'm gonna slide it back so it's level with the ledge. I'm gonna go like that. All right, then I'm gonna do it one last time. I'm gonna put that edge there so I can barely see the photo. Just tucking out, and then bam. And then you've got the perfect one. Okay, so here's another look. I know I showed you this one, which I think is pretty cool, and I kind of was motivated by the virtual crop on that one. And here's another look, just so that you can see how cool this mosaic look is. All right, I hope that helps you, and I hope you'll go try something new. Bye.